الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير وأشهد أن سيدنا وحبيبنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم اللهم صلِّ وسلِّم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وأزواجه أجمعين قال تعالى يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون وقال تعالى يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا O mankind, fear your Lord who created you from one soul and created from it its mate and dispersed from both of them many men and women. And fear Allah through whom you ask one another and the wombs. Indeed, Allah is ever over you an observer. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر المحدثات وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this verse in Surah An-Nisa which I mentioned about تساءلون به والأرحام واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام This is a very important part of that verse that keep reminding us two things. That when you are asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to solve so many of your problems and وتنشد ويقول يعني لشخص مثلا أشهدك بالله أسألك بالله ثم تذكره بأن لا يقطع الأرحام فموضوع تقطيع الأرحام موضوع خطير وموضوع مهم جدا فعندما تسأل الله وعندما أيضا تسأل شخص تقول له أنشدك بالله وأسألك بالله وتذكره بالأرحام وبصلة الرحم وأهمية صلة الرحم فهذا موضوع يذكرنا بخطورة حقوق الوالدين وعدم الإحسان إليهم وفي سورة الأحقاف الله سبحانه وتعالى يذكرنا هذا الدعاء الذي يجب أن نعلمه إلى أولادنا سأبدأ بالآية الكريمة رقم 15 في سورة الأحقاف ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا ووصينا الإنسان بوالديه إحسانا يعني this is confirmation we told and we kept telling and reminding mankind to be good to his parents to look after his parents حملته أمه كرها ووضعته كرها وحمله وفصاله 30 شهرا حتى إذا بلغ أشده وبلغ 40 سنة قال رب أوزعني أن أشكر نعمتك التي أنعمت علي وعلى والدي وأن أعمل صالحا ترضاه وأصلح لي في ذريتي إني تبت إليك وإني من المسلمين And we have enjoined upon man to his parents good treatment. His mother carried him with hardship and gave birth to him with hardship. I'll repeat, his mother carried him with hardship and gave birth to him with hardship. And his gestation and weaning period is 30 months. He grows until When he reaches maturity and reaches the age of 40 years, he says, "My Lord, enable me to be grateful for your favor which you have bestowed upon me and upon my parents, and to work righteousness of which you will approve and make righteous for me my offspring. Indeed, I have repented to you, and indeed, I am of the Muslims." فنلاحظ في هذه الآية الكريمة الله ذكر لنا الأشد والأربعين العمر عندما يبلغه الإنسان الأشد وهو عمر الثلاثين أو 33 سنة والأربعين هو عمر الرشد والعقل يكتمل عقل الإنسان في عمر الأربعين فهذه النقطة يعني يجب أن ننتبه لها أن إذا الإنسان بلغ عمر الأربعين عادة يكون أصبح عنده زوجة وأولاد واحد ولا اثنين ولا أربعة وخمسة وأمه وأبيه يصبحوا في السبعينات أو الثمانينات من العمر فهذه مرحلة خطيرة ومهمة في حياة هذا الإنسان الرجل والمرأة الزوج والزوجة فيكون عنده مسؤوليات كثيرة يكون عنده أولاد وعنده أبوين يجب أن يهتم بهما فهنا الله يذكرنا سبحانه وتعالى بهذه المسؤوليات وهذه الأمور لأن هذه مرحلة صعبة يمر بها أغلبية البشر فلذلك يطلب ثلاثة أشياء كل واحد منا يجب أن يتذكر أن يطلب ثلاثة أشياء خاصة عندما يصل مرحلة الأربعين من عمره وهي أول الأولى ربي ألهمني شكر نعمتك التي أنعمت بها علي وعلى والدي حتى ربياني صغيرا يعني طلب من الله أن يوقفه للشكر على النعمة يوفقه للشكر على النعمة فيجب أن تطلب باستمرار من الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يوفقك على الشكر على النعمة لأن الشيطان سوف يأتي ويوسوسك وشرور نفسك سوف تأتي وتوسوسك وتشغلك فأنت يجب دائما أن تتذكر بأن تطلب من الله سبحانه وتعالى على الشكر على النعمة So the first point that you need to remember in this verse is that you always regularly ask Allah to thank Him about the gift that He's given you. The wife, the husband, and the children. Because the shaitan will make you forget thanking Allah and being grateful to Allah. So you need to pray regularly and ask Allah to help you to be thankful and grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Especially at this stage when you are 40 years old. And when your wisdom becomes full at the highest stage. Second point, وَأَنْ أَعْمَلَ صَالِحًا تَرْضَاهُ So the second point is you ask Allah أَنْ تَعْمَلَ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا يَرْضَاهُ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لأنه so many people, they go through midlife crisis at this age. They think, oh, I missed so many things in my past. I wanted to do this, I wanted to do that, and this and that. So he goes into a lot of tribulation and fitna. He has plenty of money sometimes, or he has, you know, good network, good connections, and all these things. And then he will forget to do good actions, which will please Allah. So always remember to ask Allah, أن تعمل عملا صالحا ترضاه. And also, the third one, وأصلح لي في ذريتي. وأصلح لي في ذريتي. أي اجعل ذريتي ونسلي صالحين. وتطلب من الله أن ويطلب من الله أن يصلح له في ذريتي وهذه كمال السعادة البشرية. So if you can achieve these three things, asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you to be grateful to Him. And asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide you to do good actions that He is pleased with Him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala with it alone. And asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you in guiding your children and make your children good children. Because those children, imagine after the age of 40, you see every one of them is misguided and going away. And they're not helping you to look after your parents. How painful that is going to become. You have duties towards your parents. You are 40 years old or near 40. And their parents are both 70 or 80 or even 90, and your children are going astray. All over the place. Misguided. Spending so much time on TV or PlayStation or on drugs or with the wrong, hanging with the wrong crowd. So this is a very important dua that we must remember to teach ourselves and our children and our family and to teach our wives as well and our cousins. So then Allah tells us in the next verse, what's going to happen to those people who are doing this dua, who are asking Allah for these three things? أولئك الذين نتقبل عنهم أحسن ما عملوا ونتجاوز عن سيئاتهم في أصحاب الجنة وعد الصدق الذي كانوا يوعدون. Those are the ones from whom we will accept the best of what they did and overlook their misdeeds. They being among the companions of paradise. That is the promise of truth which they had been promised. So, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, سوف يدخلهم الجنة ويتجاوز عن سيئاتهم. So if you look after your parents, and if you are asking Allah to help you, to be grateful to Him, and asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make your dhurriya, your children, your offspring, good people, and they help you with your parents. So if you don't educate your children to look after their grandparents, you haven't done a good job in this life. Not only you should go and serve your parents. It's your children as well, they should go and serve their grandparents and help them and support them and feed them and look after them and clean their houses and take them shopping and take them to the park and take them to their friends. You by yourself is not good enough to look after your parents. You need the support of your children because this is part of being grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is how your children will learn to look after you when you are 80 years old or 90 years old. So this is a practical lesson. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is guiding us and teaching us that when you are near 40 and around 40 and above 40, prepare yourself to be a servant for your parents. After you finish your prayers, straight away think, what shall I feed my mother, my father? Is she cold? Is she warm? This cold weather. There are hundreds of thousands of Muslim families in London. Their grandparents are freezing and cold and they have no food. How much have we prepared for them, our grandparents? How much did we tell our father and mother, come, take me, let's go to our grandparent, let's go to our grandmother and feed her and cover her and do some shopping for her. It's -5 yesterday and before yesterday and today and probably tomorrow. It's very important. As soon as you leave this mosque, you call your parents and you call your grandparents and tell them, grandpa, grandma, what help do you need? I think my mother or my father, they're not doing enough a good job for you. I want to support them in looking after you. Tell me, I'm gonna be a better servant than my parents. So this is what you should be doing in the next 2 days in the weekend. So you apply this first and you help your parents to go to paradise. Inshallah. Now, we have a second type of people which they do bad action towards the parents. Towards their parents. And Allah is reminding us of these people. And to be aware of them and not to be like them. وَالَّذِي قَالَ لِوَالِدَيْهِ أُفٍّ لَكُمَا أَتَعِدَانَنِي أَنْ أُخْرَجَ وَقَدْ خَلَتِ الْقُرُونَ مِنْ قَبْلِي وَهُمَا يَسْتَغِيثَانِ اللَّهَ وَيْلَكَ آمِنْ إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ إِنَّ وَعْدَ اللَّهِ حَقٌّ فَيَقُولُ مَا هَذَا إِلَّا أَسَاطِيرُ الْأَوَّلِينَ. أولئك الذين حق عليهم القول في أمم قد خلت في أمم قد خلت من قبلهم من الجن والإنس إنهم كانوا خاسرين. But one who says to his parents, "Oof to you! Do you promise me that I will be brought forth from the earth when generations before me have already passed on into oblivion, while they call to Allah for help and to their son, wow to you, believe. Indeed, the promise of Allah is truth. But he says, this is not but legends of the former people. Those are the ones upon whom the word, i.e. decree, has come into effect. Who will be among nations which have passed on before them of jinn and men? Indeed, they all were losers. So, we have to tell our children and ourselves, we are going to be tested with our belief. So what kind of people? Are we going to be like this man who made fun of his parents and refused to believe in the Day of Judgment and refused to help his parents? And he refused to support his parents and take his children to his parents to support their grandparents and be lost and be losers and go to hellfire? This is the discussion you should be having today and tomorrow and after tomorrow with your children. When they argue with you, tell them, our parents are in need of our help. We should go and clean their house. We should go and buy shopping for them and wash their clothes and do everything. And if your son says, no, dad, I don't want to do that. Or your daughter says, oh, I want to put makeup. I've got appointment with my friends. I want to go to the movie. I want to go to the park. There's no school. Look, plenty of snow. I want to go to the snow, to the park and play with the snow. Why are you threatening me about this Day of Judgment? Why are you threatening me about what Allah is going to do to me? So remind him about this verse. Read for him. Read for him Surah Al-Ahqaf. Verse 18 and verse 17. And tell him, look my son, Allah is warning you and he's warning us that we're going to be tested. The same way your parents, the same way my parents look after me, I have to look after them and you have to come with me and look after them. And you, my son, you have to remind me with these two verses, 17 and 18 of Surah Al-Ahqaf. So you make sure I don't go to hellfire. Because it's very easy to claim, I'm a believer, I believe in the Day of Judgment, I believe in Allah, and I believe in paradise and hellfire. But when it comes to action, you find so many people are far away. You find so many people are far away from these actions. Especially when it comes to their parents, and looking after their parents and their grandparents. So fear Allah. One thing important I would like to remind you is that when Allah punishes someone, if he's bad to his parents or he doesn't look after his parents, the punishment will come in this dunya, behold the hereafter. The punishment will come to this dunya in his life before he dies and before the hereafter. So please, may Allah be pleased with you. Make sure that you take this issue and this point very seriously. Especially in this cold weather, especially in the snow, in this freezing weather. I know of stories of families and people, their grandparents, they're shivering, and they don't even pick up the phone and call them or contact them. And if you know your neighbor who has some grandparents or has parents who's not looking after them, tell him, I take you, my neighbor. I take you to your father and your mother to look after them, to cook for them. I will cook with you for them. I will carry the shopping with you for them. You are my neighbor. I don't want you to go to hellfire. I want you to go to paradise. And I'm going to help you with that. And even if you have an argument or fight with your parents, I'll take you. I'll cook with you. So your father and your mother will feel that you have the good friend. Let them see that the children could have good friends. It's a big issue. It's a big issue in this weather. Astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li jami'i al-muslimin. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. A few weeks ago, we were talking about our future. We live in London, and jobs in London are changing, and so many things are going to happen. The technology is developing very fast. Computers are becoming more powerful. And there's a small reminder, I would just like to remind you from Surah Yusuf, that we Muslims, how we should be planning when we are going through changes. I just briefly read that verse and read the lesson from it, and inshallah, maybe after the khutbah, because it's very cold outside, I need to finish quickly and wrap this khutbah, inshallah. So I'll explain more in details inshallah, if those of you who are interested, after the prayer, you can sit down and discuss it more in details. But I just briefly tell you the verses, inshallah. Surah Yusuf, verse 43.
وَقَالَ الْمَلِكُ إِنِّي أَرَى سَبْعَ بَقَرَاتٍ سِمَانٍ يَأْكُلْهُنَّ سَبْعٌ عِجَافٍ.
Just briefly, very short.
وقال الملك إني أرى سبع بقرات سمان يأكلهن سبع عجاف وسبع سنبلات خضر وأخر يابسات يا أيها الملأ أفتوني أفتوني في رؤياي إن كنتم للرؤيا تعبرون.
Then I'll move to what Yusuf answered after a few verses, briefly.
قال تزرعون سبع سنين دأبا فما حصدتم فذروه في سنبله إلا قليلا مما تأكلون ثم يأتي من بعد ذلك سبع شداد يأكلن ما قدمتم لهن إلا قليلا مما تحصنون ثم يأتي من بعد ذلك عام فيه يغاث الناس وفيه يعصرون.
So this surah, Surah Yusuf, Allah is teaching us a lesson that things happen to nations, to families, to cities, and they have to plan for the next 7 years, for the next 5 years, or for the next 14 years. And we, in the UK, we live in a city which is going through technological changes. I mentioned in a lecture 2 weeks ago that when you go to hospital, it's no more the GP that will decide whether you're going to stay in hospital. It is a group of robots or one robot, they will analyze your body and decide whether you'll be admitted or not. And artificial intelligence and robotics and all these parts and bits and pieces that are connected to it, they are affecting our future. When you live in the forest, you teach your son how to protect himself from a lion or from a leopard or from a snake. When you live in a city, a sophisticated city like London, you teach your son and your daughter about technology. You teach your son and your daughter about artificial intelligence. You teach your son and your daughter about robotics, because they're going to be in the streets. They're going to be communicating with you. Streets, schools, hospitals. So please make sure that after the khutbah, inshallah, you come and you discuss with me how you can advise your children about their education, because this priority was jazakumullah khairan. إني داع فأمنه الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء ربنا لا تؤاخذنا إن نسينا أو أخطأنا ربنا ولا تحمل علينا إصرا كما حملته على الذين من قبلنا ربنا ولا تحملنا ما لا طاقة لنا به واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واعف عنا واغفر لنا وارحمنا أنت مولانا فانصرنا على القوم الكافرين اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم أرنا الحق حقا وارزقنا اتباعه وأرنا الباطل باطلا وارزقنا اجتنابه اللهم ارحم المسلمين ووحد صفوفهم وأعنهم على أن يساعدوا بعضهم في كل مكان اللهم أعنهم على أن يغيثوا بعضهم ويساعدوا بعضهم ويعفوا عن بعضهم يا رب العالمين ويوحدوا صفوفهم اللهم أعنهم على أن يوحدوا صفوفهم إنك على كل شيء قدير والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين قوموا لصلاتكم وباركوا فيكم